Yeah, hello everyone. Myself Naveen. Welcome to Naresh Shetty. So today we are going to discuss about UI development. Okay. So we are actually planning for the complete web series for UI development. So this is just like a trailer. So what is UI development and what are the technologies involved in the UI development and what applications we are going to develop. So let's have a trailer. Okay. Let's get started with UI development. So for all my courses, there is a subtitle from zero to hero. It means we start with zero knowledge of UI development. After that, once we complete the UI development, we'll assure that you will become the hero of UI development. Okay, so let's get started. So there are different names for UI development. Some people call it as GUI, some people call it as UI, some people call it as UX, and some people call it as front end. Okay, so GUI stands for graphical user interface, and UI stands for user interface, and UX stands for user experience and front end. These are all one and the same. Okay, these are all related to the UI development. Okay, so all the names one and the same. So next, first we'll start with, so why UI concept has come in software industry and why everybody started using UI in their own regular terminology. Okay, so see, if two human beings are there, if they want to talk to each other, if they want to share some information between each other, they want to exchange some information between each other, it requires language as well as body language, right? So if two human beings are there, they want to talk to each other, they want to share some information between each other, so it requires language as well as body language. So same case, you can see one person, he want to interact with a machine. Okay, if two human beings are there, we can talk with one or other language, right? But when it comes to the opposite thing is a machine, so we can't talk, right? Obviously we can't talk with the system, right? So what is the way? So how can we interact with the system? How a user can interact with a system? The thing is with the concept of UI. Okay, so system cannot talk. What is other way? The other way is messages. Okay, so if it is showing some messages on the screen, so it will be very easy, right? You can able to something, right? So that is the concept of UI. Sir, how the ways of communication happens between a user and the system? See, these are the ways. Okay, messages. If any system of any machine, it is showing some messages, you can read it, right? So if you can able to read the messages, so it is conveying some information to you, right? So you are getting some information and by seeing images. So you can understand, yes, something is there, right? And graphical design. So graphical design explain what is the flow and all. So you are getting some information from the system. Same way, forms. So for forms, you are giving your own inputs to the system. So from your side, you are giving some information to the system. So the communication happens between you and the machine with the concept of UI, okay? So now you understood. If two human beings are there, they want to talk to each other, it requires a language. Same way, if any other human being, they want to interact with a machine, it requires the concept of UI. Okay, so next, so UI is not a new concept. Okay, it is just old concept. So there are different types of UI, mainly three types of UI. The very first one is operating system. Sir, how can you say operating system is one UI? Simple. You just purchase a laptop today, right? It doesn't have any operating system or something, right? So it just contains only command prompt. So how you interact with your laptop? You can't see folders, you can't see images, you can't see videos and all, you can't play games. First you have to install operating system, right? So any one operating system you can install, and after that you can able to see all the folders and structures. So you can able to see the movies and you can play games, so everything. So whatever the interaction will happen, that is with the concept of operating system UI, right? So operating system is also one kind of UI. Next, customer devices. So if you go to any shopping mall, so there will be the consumers, the operators, they are working on one kind of system, right? So they will be entering something, some information. That is also one UI, right? And if you go to ATM machine, see, ATM machine is the best example. You know, you no need to go to physically to any bank and get the amount, right? Directly go to ATM machine and just insert the card and it asks some information, so give the information and you'll get the cash. So how the interaction happens? You are a human being and that's a machine. So how the interaction happened between? There's a concept of UI, right? Even metro e-tickets counter. So if you want to book a ticket, right? If you want to get a ticket, no need to go physically and just ask for the ticket, right? So you can do it by yourself. So that is the concept of UI, that is customer devices. Okay, and the last one, websites. You know, ICICI Bank is one website. Okay, you no need to go to physically to the ICICI Bank and you can do all the transactions. You can do everything in online, right? So ICICI Bank online banking is there, right? So there you can do everything online. So no need to go to physically to the bank. So whatever the bank transactions are happening in the ICICI Bank, so that is everything is there with the concept of UI. So you can directly interact with it and you can do all the transactions at your own service place, right? So that is UI. And please note, in the entire UI development, we are not going to discuss about operating system UI. We are not going to discuss about customer devices. We are purely discussing about website. So for the website, what are the technologies are involved and what are the applications, what are the websites we are trying to, we are going to develop. So everything we will see in the next slides. Okay. Yeah. So there is a definition for UI development. Yeah. Here is the definition. Simple. Why the UI concept has come? One human want to interact with a machine, right? If one human want to interact with a machine, so you have to build that. You have to develop the front end of that, right? So UI development means it is one process. It is one process of building, process of developing a front end of any application by using various technologies for better interaction with a human and machine. Better interaction with human and machine, it's required one UI. So for that UI, there is a process to develop it by using various technologies. Simple. UI development contains various technologies. So by using that, you'll build one web front end of any application so that a person can interact with. Okay, that is UI. Next, so we understood UI, we understood the websites and all, right? So after that, sir, how a normal web application, any web application, okay, we talk about a front end of any application, right? So how the web application works? What is architecture? So here is the architecture. You know, any basic web application looks like this. Okay, any application, it looks like this. Only three parts: client, server, and database. Client, server, and database. Simple. We all have Facebook account, right? So let's understand how the Facebook works with this architecture. How the Facebook works with this architecture. See, you have in your own laptop, you have one browser, right? So in the browser, you have entered your username and password. Click on login button. Once you click on login button in your browser, so it sends immediately one HTTP request to the Facebook server. It sends HTTP request to the Facebook server. What Facebook server will do is, it does some process. It does some process and it sends again request back to the database and asking, hey database, hey Facebook database, this is one person, Naveen, he is trying to access to our Facebook account. Could you please check he is a valid customer of Facebook or not, right? So that will check in the database. So database just execute one SQL query. So once you'll get the one record at least, it sends response back to the server stating, yes, he is a valid customer and this is what his information. So please do the process and give him the actual page. So what server does is, it does the actual process and then it sends back the response to the client so that you can able to see the actual page, whatever the friend requests you have, what are the notifications and everything, all the chat information, everything you can able to see. So normally any web application works like this in this architecture, okay, client, server and database. So for each web application, there are different technologies, okay. So let's understand what are the technologies used for the web. See, the very first column is client side and the middle one is server side development and last one is database. So you name any web application, they are using one or other database and one or other server side technology, and it is same client side. Client side is always same. So we'll start from database, okay. So they'll be using Oracle database, they'll be using MySQL, they'll be using SQL Server. So there are different types of databases they'll be using, depend on the projects, okay. When it comes to server side, PHP, .NET and Java. These are the three major technologies they will be using for server-side coding. The server-side processing, they'll use this technology. When it comes to client side, these are the technologies: HTML, CSS, JavaScript, Bootstrap and AngularJS. Okay. Sir, why all these technologies for client side? Why can't you choose one best technology and start using it? Right? Because each technology having its own purpose, its own logic, its own syntax, and the purpose is different. Okay. So let's start with HTML. Before that, so these three are the core languages to develop any website. Okay, if you know HTML, CSS and JavaScript is enough. You can develop any website, whatever is there as of today. Okay, and Bootstrap, it adds some responsiveness. So we'll discuss about this in the next slide. Yeah, UI technologies. So there are So UI is not a technology. So there's a combination of technologies used in UI. So that's why we call it UI technologies. So some technologies in the part of UI. If you want to develop a UI of any website, you must use all the following technologies. Okay. First, we start with HTML. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. So why HTML is required? So you know, HTML is required to just display one content on a web page. Just a content, no styles, no animation, nothing. Just a content. Same like your textbook. So your textbook, you have headings, paragraphs, images, right? So it's like black and white textbook. So same like that, if you want to same textbook content, if you want to display on a web page, so you must use HTML. So this is like a static language. Okay, sir, what is mean by static? Simple. For HTML, okay, we'll take the textbook example. Same. Today you have some content. Okay, so you read one content, and tomorrow you open the same book, same content. After 10 years, same content. After 100 years, same content. It means what? Content is static. It means HTML, by using only HTML, if you develop any website, it is static. When it comes to browsers, when it comes to websites, it is developed by using only HTML. It is always static. Means if you refresh the browser, you can able to see some data. If you refresh 100 times, same data. 1000 times, same data. 1 crore times, same data. It means what? It is a static. It is static. So you can develop any static web page, any static content. If you want to display on a web page, you must use HTML. And then CSS. Sir, why CSS? So CSS stands for cascading style sheets. So CSS is used to add some extra styles to your text. Simple. HTML also having some styles, white color background, white black color text, and Times New Roman font, right? So if you want to override the style, so if you want to add red color background and white color text and all the styles and all margin padding and all this, so you just want to add some extra makeup to the content, you have to use CSS. Okay, and I can say HTML, CSS, both are static. See, simple. You have applied some extra CSS to the HTML content, so that red color background, white color text for your web page. So you just reload the browser, same red color background, white color text, right? You reload again, same red color background, same white color text. So reload 100 times, same styles, same content. It means what? Even though you combine with HTML with CSS, it is always same static content. Sir, how to get the dynamic nature? So that is by using JavaScript. So JavaScript is a programming language for browsers as scripting. By using JavaScript, you can add some dynamic nature to your website. Okay, and the next one is jQuery. So jQuery is a library which is built on top of JavaScript. So simple. If you want to develop a component by using JavaScript, it will take around 100 lines of code, right? So by using jQuery, it is there already by using one method. So they have implemented the component already. You just have to use that method and your work will be done. Means, so just you need to call the method and your work will be done. That is jQuery. And next, Bootstrap. So this is advanced. So Bootstrap is a framework for HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So Bootstrap is a framework for HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Sir, why Bootstrap has come all of a sudden? So sir, you told only HTML, CSS, and JavaScript is enough for developing any website. Why Bootstrap has come? See, 7.5 years back or 7 to 8 years back, if you see, there is no smartphones, there is no tablets. Sir, how? Yeah, without Bootstrap, you can develop a website that works for large screens, that works for TVs, that works for laptops and desktop, but that is not compatible with tablets and mobile. So you can't exactly feel like it's not compatible with mobile. So sir, how to get the compatibility for mobile? So you will get the compatibility for mobiles by using Bootstrap. So there are two ways. By using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript also, you can get this compatibility for your website. For this, only two options. At least you should have 10 plus years of experience on UI development so that you can make that compatible with mobile browsers, or else with a basic knowledge of HTML and CSS, just learn the Bootstrap, it will be done. Okay, so that is the beauty of Bootstrap. And the core advantage of Bootstrap is it works for all the browsers, all the operating system, it works for all the devices. Even it works for perfectly for mobiles, tablets, laptops, desktops, and even larger screens. And even works for all the browsers. You name any modern browser, it works perfectly for all the browsers. And even it works for all the operating systems. So Windows, Android, anything you name, it works for perfectly for all the operating system, right? So that is the beauty of Bootstrap. And the next one, TypeScript. So in UI development, we'll be learning the concept called TypeScript. So TypeScript, simple. It is a superset of JavaScript. So you just need to write those classes, interfaces and all. It compiles back to the pure JavaScript and that will be working. So why we are learning TypeScript is, in future you may learn Angular 5. The new advanced version which has come is Angular 5. So Angular 5 is built on top of TypeScript. So you should have the strong foundation on TypeScript. So here you will use ECMAScript 6 features, right? So for that reason, we'll be covering TypeScript also in this concept. And finally, we'll start with AngularJS. So AngularJS, simple. If you want to, so two things are there in AngularJS. If you want to implement the MVC architecture in the client side, you will use AngularJS. And you want to get the two-way data binding. It's like one drum is full of water and this is full of water and there is a pipe between. Okay, so this water level is exactly same. So this is like a backend, this is like a front end, and data is everything same. This is like a model and this is like a view. So data is always same. So it's always syncing. So this kind of two-way data binding will be happen by using AngularJS. So this is the framework. This is the most powerful framework for front end. Okay. So this is about UI technologies, and next we'll just see what is the difference between HTML and CSS. So if you just use one HTML, it will be like this. If you just add a HTML along with CSS, it looks like this. Okay, so which one you want? You want to add CSS or you just stick with the HTML? Okay, this is how the website looks like. Okay, and next, what tools you'll be using in the entire application development. So we are not going to use Notepad or Notepad++ because we are doing a lot of applications. So Notepad or Notepad++ is not going to work out. So we will be using these editors, Atom, Sublime Text, and this brackets and Visual Studio Code, and even we can use the IDE WebStorm. So these are the tools we'll be using for website development. Okay. Yeah. Next, HTML5 learning plan. Sir, we are all new to the UI development and we don't know HTML, we don't know CSS. How can we do it? See, you are saying a lot of technologies are there and you want to build one application, you must have to use all the combination of all the technologies to develop, right? Sir, how can we know that all are different technology? How can we learn and how can we develop the lot of applications using these things? Simple. My way of learning is very simple. First, we'll start with HTML5. HTML5, the complete, all the tags of HTML, simple. In HTML, there are 25 to 30 tags are there. I just divided HTML tags to 3 parts. First, we will learn the 10 tags and then we'll build one mini project. After that, we'll learn the next 10 tags. We'll build one mini project that is called as online Java application form. And then we'll learn the remaining 10 tags and then we start with one mini project that is company website. So that if you have done like this in this way, so first only by using 10 tags you develop one project, only by using the 10 tags you develop one project, only by using last 10 tags you will be developing one project. So I'll show you what are the projects we will be going to develop. I'll just give you the demo. So in this way, if you learn, it's very easy. So I can say once you develop all these three, you will become the hero of HTML. And then we start with CSS. And CSS also, there is a learning plan. There are simple, only some 25 to 30 components are there. So first we learn all the components, so like text, colors, fonts, margins, padding, animations, and everything we learn. After that, we build one complete website, that is one mini project, that is technology portal website. Okay. After that, so once you have developed the complete project using this HTML and CSS, you will become the hero of CSS. Okay. Next, we start learning with JavaScript. So in JavaScript, we will be learning ECMAScript 5 version. So JavaScript also called as ECMAScript. So ECMAScript 5 version, we will be learning. We learn all the concept of JavaScript and then we build one mini project by using HTML, CSS and complete JavaScript. That is typing tester app. Same like one simple typing tester app. So timer will start it once you start typing. So I'll just show you the demo after this. Next, we start with TypeScript along with ECMAScript 6 features. We learn all the ECMAScript 6 features along with the TypeScript and then we build one complete mini project by using the pure object-oriented way of TypeScript, that is simple calculator app. So after that, we start with Bootstrap 4. So we are not going to learn simple Bootstrap. We are going to learn the material design Bootstrap along with all the projects. So first, we learn all the concepts of Bootstrap 4. So we are learning advanced version of Bootstrap 4 that was released in January 18, 2018. So that we will be learning, and in that we will be doing 3 major projects. The very first major project is online resume. So we all having hard copy resume, same like that we will be developing one online resume, and next one is one UI dashboard website and then one corporate website. So we will be developing 3 different types of websites, the fully totally different architecture. Okay, so we'll be developing Bootstrap with three major projects, and finally we start with AngularJS. And in AngularJS also we learn all the components, and finally we'll be doing 5 mini apps, and finally one last major Grokkery list app, that is a complete code app. You can create, update, read, delete, everything, all the operations will be happening in that AngularJS. Okay, so this AngularJS will be mixed with Bootstrap 4 along with Material Design. Okay, so that's a full-fledged application. So I'll just show you the demo of how HTML applications will works, and how the JavaScript application, everything. I'll just show you the demo and then we'll come back. Yeah, so this is the UI development, my folder, and here we'll be learning HTML, CSS, JavaScript, TypeScript, Bootstrap, AngularJS and all. So first we start with HTML. So in the HTML we'll be having one starter template and one complete template. So in the complete template we start learning with headings, paragraph, div, span and all, and finally there are some 31 files are there, and we'll just first we will learn from 1 to 12 tags. See, 1 to 12 tags, and then there is no 13th is mini project. So we'll be developing on first mini project on HTML, that is this. Yeah, so this is the very first HTML, the HTML first mini project. So the Great India website, it contains our India map and Indian flag, and here actually YouTube video will be playing in your app. And this is great Indian freedom fighters, and this is political leaders, Indian business leaders and sports leaders, and done, right? So here you can click on freedom fighters, it goes to freedom fighters. If you click on business leaders, it goes to business leaders. So this is a very simple app we will be developing by using just the basic 10 tags, start of 10 tags. After that we will be learning the next 10 tags, that is like form tags. So after learning the form tags, we will be developing one complete job application form only by using those next 10 tags, all the form tags. So this is a simple job application form, online job application form. So here personal information, educational details, work experience 2, work experience 3, and then other details and simple CSS button. So we'll be developing this complete application just by using those whatever the form tags we'll be learning. And after that we will be learning the HTML5 version, like header, footer, sides and all. So, and then we'll develop the complete project only on those tags along with little CSS. This is, so here you can see the main navigation, and this is the sidebar, and this is like details tag, this is CSS and all. So this is the application we'll be developing. So this is the third mini project. So only in the HTML, this is first mini project, this is second mini project, this is third mini project. If you can able to develop all these three applications, I can assure that you are the hero of HTML. Okay, so next we start with CSS. So in CSS also there are two parts again, starter template, complete template. So in the complete template, if you go here, yeah, we start with CSS colors, backgrounds, margins, borders, outlines and everything. I'll just show you some examples here. CSS forms, yeah, this is one form. So we learn all the all the components of CSS. So I'm just showing the components of CSS. Horizontal navigation bar. So these are the components of CSS. This is one horizontal navigation bar. So this is horizontal navigation, and if you want to get the vertical navigation, that is this. Yeah, this is the vertical navigation. So like this, there are 30 components are there. Even we learned with image gallery. Let me show you that image gallery. So this is the image gallery. So this is nice hover effect and all. So we'll be learning the complete 30 components of CSS, and finally I'll show you little animation, that is this. This is very simple animation. This is just scrolling the flash news, and then this animation. So the animation is like start with a square and finally it turns back to the circle. See, you can observe. So after that, so this is one animation, if you throw a ball, how it will be moving and all. So that is one CSS animation. So like this, we will learn all the CSS components, that is around 30 components are there. So once we done with all the components, we will be developing one complete mini project only on by using HTML and CSS, no JavaScript. So here, yeah, just see this. This is first mini project, only one mini project is there in CSS, that is this UI Brands Techno Portal. So this is our latest news. So it just contains laptop news, mobile news and tablet news. This is one nice hover effect, and this is, see, this is one image. So it is little opacity, we call as, so it comes as little clear one. So this is the border, I mean this is the footer. So if you go to the top, news section, yeah, this is again same old news will be there. So if you go to gallery section, so this is the simple gallery, so mobiles, laptops, tablets and all, and then we go for about us page, so about us, who we are, what we develop and our clients and all. And finally, if you go to contact us page, so this is the contact us page, so simple contact us page. Okay, so we will be developing the complete CSS, whatever the things we learn as of now with all the 30 components, and finally we'll be developing this complete application, this complete website. So if you have done this by your own, you are the hero of CSS. And after that we start with JavaScript. So let me show you the JavaScript. So we start with the JavaScript. So in the JavaScript we have again complete template. So we start with basics, inline, internal, external variable declaration, data types, operations and all. And finally we'll be developing one mini project on JavaScript. I'll just show you the demo for this one. Yeah, this is one simple typing tester app. So whatever the text is there here, you have to start typing here. As soon as you enter a character, the timer will start. So if you are entering correctly, if you are entering the correct details, so border will be blue color. If you are entering any one character wrong, it is turned to red color. And if everything is success, it turns to green color and timer will stop. Yeah, just see the coding now. So thanks for, see, I'm typing wrong. So it is turned to red color. And as soon as you type enter, yes, it is done. It is properly, whatever it is there here, it is entered and timer stopped here, right? It turns to green color. And if you click on reset, it will be reset. And here you can add any of your own paragraph and you can start typing it, okay? This is by using HTML, CSS as well as JavaScript. And then after that, we will be learning TypeScript, okay? So in the TypeScript also, we will learn all the components. And finally, we'll do one mini project that is this one. So this is one simple calculator app we will be developing by using TypeScript. So here you can just enter 120 and 120. So here whatever the button you press, it comes over there. See, plus, minus, slash, star. So 120 plus 120 equal to 240 minus 0 slash this one star this one and done. So click on clear, everything got clear. Okay, this is very very simple app. So we'll be developing by using TypeScript, how we can develop any application by using TypeScript. So that is this one. And next one, we'll start learning Bootstrap. So in the Bootstrap, we will be learning, these are the components here. So if you go to complete templates, SRC, so these are the files. First, we'll start with the basic first app, basic typography, float, positions, colors, backgrounds and all. So let me show you something called buttons. So we are not going to learn simple Bootstrap, we are learning the material design Bootstrap. So this is material design Bootstrap buttons. So all the different styles of buttons, large button, block level button and all, drop downs and all. So we will be learning everything in the classroom itself. So and then, so like this, there are almost 25 components are there. There is one component called model. Let's see the model. So if you click on login, so one login form will come. So this is one model. So we click on this, yeah. It's nothing else there. Yeah, this is the login model. So once we develop all this, and we'll be developing three major projects. So I told one is online resume. So that online resume is this one. So you all having hard copy resume, right? Same like this, you have this is online resume. So this is my name and my photo, and this is what my experience. And if you click on home section, so what my page and what my skills and what are the HTML, CSS and progress bars, and click on resume. Let me show you like this. Yeah, click on resume. So where I have work and what are all the roles and responsibilities here, and what are the information of phone numbers and years and all. So this is we call as cards and work experience. So here what we build and what are all this. So if you click on this, it comes one simple light box. So you can add your own whatever website you have developed. So just take the images and keep here, and that will become the complete full-fledged application. And finally, contact section. If you click on the contact section, yeah, username, email, messages, and click on submit query. This is very very simple application, online resume. This is the first major project we'll be developing. And then, So, and then if you go to one more application, that is admin dashboard. Admin dashboard. So this is one application where we call as admin dashboard. So this is simple admin dashboard here. If you click on add post, this is contents, dashboard, post, categories and users. This is like a website dashboard. Okay. So if you click on add post, you can add posts and all this. You can select this one and click on click on close. It closes. Okay. So click on add category. So it opens add category and all. And then if you click on add user, so you can add a user here. And here, see right side, 7 posts, 4 categories and this users. If you click on this one, it goes to post page. And if you go back, if you click on this one, it goes to categories page. And again, if you click on this one, it goes to users page, right? So even you can directly click here, click on post page and you can have a nice search box and all these posts. And click on categories, these are all the different categories are there. And then click on users. So these are all the different types of users are there. You can have a nice search box and I have logged in, right? So you can click on the profile, you can see my profile and everything, and click on change the password. So you can even change the password, confirm password, and click on close and back to dashboard. And you see here it is a nice zoom effect. So everything is there. And then you can go to settings page. So there are some simple settings are there. And if you click on back to dashboard and click on logout, if you click on logout, it comes to the login page. So you can add some information. Okay, so you can add like this and click on it, it opens again. Okay, this is a full-fledged application, and please note, this is not the, there is no backend, there is no database, it is just a template, so because your development, it comes only for the template. That is one, this one. And finally, we'll develop one last major project, that is corporate website. So let me show you that corporate website, that is this. So this is one simple corporate website. It is having nice animation and all. So this is, we call as slider. So one simple slider is there in the Bootstrap. And then best faculty members, best coding skills, best course material. We provide best training for Java as well as front end and all this. This is called as Lightbox. Okay. And then come down. So India's number one institute and Java completed course, AngularJS, Bootstrap and all these components. If you click on contact us. So this is your contact us page and you can leave some messages. So this is the footer, and if you click on, if you go to go back to the top section, you click on about page. So what about this information and meet the trainers? This is myself. So these are all some other trainers. So this is my, okay, this is like simple card. Okay, this is nice hover effect and all. And then if you go to services, so what services we provide, and this is the reception, and these are all cards. These are called as Bootstrap cards. And then price details. So these are called as these are again cards, and it contains list items. So silver plan, gold plan, platinum plan, everything is there. And 1 year plan, all this. So if you click on here, for every bottom here one link here, if you click on it, it goes to top. And click on contact section. This is contact us and contact information, and here is get in touch. So here you can add address, and this is one inquiry form. You can even click on contact form and you can do it, or you can do the inquiry form here, right? So this is very, very simple application we will be developing. This is the third major project. So here, this is first major project, this is second major project, this is third major project. So everything we will be doing in the classroom session, in the live coding. And finally we start with AngularJS. So in AngularJS, if you go to complete template, in AngularJS each one file is one app. Okay, so let me show you that. See, this is just a welcome message, welcome to AngularJS. So along with AngularJS, you'll be using Bootstrap and material design. And then, so if you go to ng-if and ng-show, so this is one simple controller we use for AngularJS. So that is this. So select your age. If your age is greater than 30, get married soon, or no, get a job. Okay, this is very, very simple application. Just want to show the demo for ng-if and ng-show. And then ng-model. So ng model, so I told, right, AngularJS is having two-way data binding. So the very first one, the green color one, is the front end, and the teal color one is the back end, I mean the model. So whatever you types in here, see, it will be affecting here. So whatever the email and password, whatever you added, and even for checkbox, if you check it, it is true. If you uncheck, it is false. Even you can click on validate, validation success. See, this is one app. Okay, this is called as two-way data binding demo for AngularJS. And then we start with ng controller. This is one simple controller app, this likes app. So you have to click on likes. So see, as soon as you press the like, the total is increasing. The total means just likes plus dislikes. So simple. As soon as you press it, it keep increasing. This is one app, and then we start with clock app. That is by using AngularJS. So simple, Indian time it is today. This is the time, and USA this is the time, and China this is the time. So okay, this is a lot of JavaScript is required in the backend. So that will be doing with AngularJS, and then so there is one nested controllers. This is the concept where parent controller whatever is having by default available to the child controller. So whatever you type here, it comes directly automatically to the child controller. This is one simple demo. And then one simple calculator app. This same app we have developed by using TypeScript also. So simple. So if you type, you can click on plus symbol. If you click on hyphen, it is minus. And if you slash and star and click on clear, it clears the calculator app. Okay. So after that, there is one ng show, ng hide controller demo. So that is this. So this is one simple hobby selection app. So if you click on edits, so eating, coding and sleeping, you can just select your hobbies. So it comes automatically. As soon as you uncheck, it goes away. Okay. So that is one simple app. And after that ng repeats. So in the ng repeat also, there is one simple app. This is called as good morning app. So you can add your name here. Okay. So how many number of times you want to say good morning? If you press one, only one time. As soon as you press, so if you add two, it will be two times. Even if you forgot your name, you can add here, right? This is one simple good morning app. And final one, the curd app, the complete curd app. So create, update, read and delete. So this is crockery list app. Here you can add a crockery and click on add. So let me add something, add a biscuits, click on add item. If you click on add item, it will be adding in the bottom, right? So here you can say wine here, and click on edit item, add item, it will be added. So you want to edit all these items. So click on edit item and you can just change. This is biscuits 10 and wine, you can say some 25. Okay, you have added some changes and click on done. So it will be, changes will be updated. Even if you want to delete, sir, I don't want wine, just click on delete, done. Okay, so this is very simple curd application by using AngularJS. Okay, so these are all the apps we will be developing in the entire UI development course. Okay, so we are not going to use any of the Notepad++ or Notepad. So we'll be developing by using this one, and we'll be using by using editors. And one final thing, sir, do we have to develop by using scratch code? No, there is a basic skeleton is available in the Google. So just go to Google. Yeah, just go to Google and type in my name here. So you will get the very first link, that is GitHub link. So just open that link. So here you can able to see my profile and all. So here actual code will be there. See, HTML development, CSS, JavaScript, TypeScript, Bootstrap and AngularJS. If you go to HTML, this link here. So here you can clone or download. You can download the complete source code here. And this is the starter template. So if you click on this one, so all the, see, that is mini project and all the files and folders of HTML. Like this, we are having the complete skeleton here. So this is not the complete code here. This is just a skeleton. So you must have to come to the classes regularly and just follow my tutorials and even video sessions so that you'll get the complete template, whatever the applications will be developing. Okay. So this is just a trailer for UI development. So we'll be doing the complete web series for UI development. So keep watching. Thank you.